Joker. This is an R-rated crime drama thriller movie around 2 hours and 2 minutes long. This came out on the 4th of October 2019. This was directed, written and produced by Todd Phillips, but also co-produced by Bradley Cooper. The story of this being in comedian Arthur Fleck, who's also mentally troubled throughout this movie in Gotham City. He goes down a downward spiral road where he's going down this revolution and bloodied crime, and it also leads him face to face with his new alter ego, the Joker. Straight into the good points. Now, the good points about this movie is, let's jump straight into the performances of the actors. Really, we get some great performances, starting off with Robert De Niro as Murray Franklin. Murray Franklin is a TV host, which is really full of himself. He's got this show, he's comedian, he's cocky, he's full of himself, and he really hits the nail on the head with this character. Not only that, with his interaction with Arthur Fleck, obviously the Joker in this movie, really is fun and really intriguing to see. Alongside him, we have Frances Conroy as Penny Fleck, the mother of Arthur Fleck, the Joker. She really was special in this movie as well. She wasn't in it a bunch, but what she was in it and the way the story planned out for her character was really interesting. Now, the final one, obviously, the main star of the movie is Joaquin Phoenix. Now, can he even beat or come close to Heath Ledger's performance in The Dark Knight? That is the big question over this movie. For me, yes, he does. I think he absolutely deserves Oscars in this movie. Even nominations would be a great, great achievement for him. And the movie in general deserves for Oscars as well. It really is great. But really, with this guy, Joaquin Phoenix, he hits a nail on the head with his character. It brings a brand new laugh, which is unique, with pain in his voice. It really mixes well with the character through what he's gone through. Now, Joaquin Phoenix basically owns this movie, as you'd expect with the Joker character being the main character. And he won the hearts of me and many others around the world, even just movie lovers, not fans of the Joker character. He's won many, many hearts over with this performance. Now, with Joaquin Phoenix as well, he has the look for the character in this movie throughout the movie, really, really fits the mold of the character perfectly, as well as just the way he sounds, not just the laugh, but how he talks as well, the way he says things in a way. It's sort of one part he really sounded like Heath Ledger a little bit, and it really was fun and really intriguing to see. Now, the idea of normally a superhero type movie is normally good guy versus bad guy. This movie just chucks that away and goes, you know what, we're going to focus on a bad guy. That was something I was skeptical about, and many others doing a standalone Joker movie, but I'm so glad they did it, because the way they went about it was just so great. And what they did is they just were so original and unique with how they handled this character, especially after all the controversy, all the bad things that's happened to this character throughout movies, games and all the stuff which many people and fans have been complaining about. Now, one thing I came out very, very surprised with, as well as in the movie surprised with, was the sympathy I had towards the character. Arthur Fleck goes through a lot in this movie, and we get to understand how he goes from being Arthur to the Joker in this movie, and the sympathy was something which was well built. It wasn't over the top, and it was really balanced, because you can generally see there's something wrong with this guy, and you know, obviously, oh, I feel sorry for him. Do you know what? Yeah, he's quite scary and intimidating. So it's a good balance, and really the things that happen to Arthur is bad, and we can understand why he goes the way he goes, but the things he's doing we just can't agree with, even though we understand. So it's sort of that realism in there, which I really did respect of what they did, and I just think it was really nice seeing it from the villain's eyes rather from Batman's eyes, which was a cool aspect of it. The overall story, guys, is absolutely really well written and really well portrayed. It's realistic, it's deep, it's gritty, it's dramatic. The drama side of the movie really was great, and because of all them things, it really didn't feel like a superhero movie. That's what made it so unique to, compared to other movies. Now, the beginning to end of the Joker, the way he becomes Arthur Fleck to Joker, is absolutely handled phenomenally. It really is. There are generally some shocking moments. Even though you think of Joker, twisted evil stuff, there's generally some shocking moments you think, oh my god, that's how I actually reacted a couple of times in this movie. Directors and the producers in this movie deserve a lot of credit. We've already spoke about actors, but the directors and the writing team as well as the producers, Todd Phillips, Bradley Cooper, and a bunch of other great names in this movie on the credits, really deserve a lot of credit with how they handled that. Lean on to the technical side of things though, the cinematography, oh my god. It was absolutely amazing. You could tell this was a blockbuster type movie. They put a lot into this. It was amazing. Mixed with that color grading, they really done a great job with that. Mixing with that, we had a pacing in this movie, which I want to give big, big credit to, because even though I'm not a big fan of slow-paced movies, it has to be a really special movie. Now, this was very slow-paced, but when it got into what it got into, it was great. And for me to enjoy this type of movie, it has to be great. That's the one thing I do want to give mention to. The pacing can be slow in the first hour or so, but really kicks into it. But when that pacing is slow, the way they handle things and what they do is just so special. Have a score in this movie that which really, really complements the movie so well, as well as the other music they use. It was really fun in how they use some of the music, and I really have to give great compliments technically. Obviously, there's going to be some sort of action. There wasn't a ton of action, but we come out still satisfied with what action we get. We feel good because the main focus is the Joker and how he becomes the Joker. It isn't about Joker starting off going to kill a load of people and then really trying to get Batman going against him. It isn't nothing like that. It's how he becomes a Joker and what pushes him to get to that level. And it really is something special with what they do here. And you still come out feeling like, you know what? What action I've got, is I'm still satisfied, which barely is really even fought nowadays when it comes to action-packed movies. I love the fact that I left the cinema wanting more. It felt like a TV series which I've just binged through, and I can't wait to see the next season. That's how I feel with this movie. It's got me questioning, thinking about a ton of things, also thinking about society and mental illnesses and stuff. It really has got me thinking, and I think they've done a great job with showing modern-day society in here, how people can be twisted, and why they do the things they do, why people suffer and things like that. But not only that, how horrible the world and people can really be, but also have a bright side to it as well, how some people can want to help and stuff like that. It has a mixed bag of emotions, which I really did enjoy. The movie's aim, I think, was to make people feel uncomfortable and uneasy with this character and his motives, and I think they've done a great job with that. I left the cinema feeling, do you know what? This guy was super twisted. Now, we've seen Heath Ledger do it in the past. He was twisted. He had a funny laugh. He really was just going against Batman, pretty much. And he done things in that movie which was quite twisted. But this movie took it to a whole new level. I really felt uneasy with what the Joker wanted to do, how he done things and what he did and stuff. There was so much twisted stuff, which really I have to give a great applause to. Hearing a lot of people are unhappy with this movie, with the way they make people feel it's okay to do what the Joker does, I disagree. It's completely a load of rubbish. It really is, because I can see what people are saying and understanding to a certain degree, but my opinion, it's a load of rubbish in my opinion. There is some problems with the movie in terms of what things you can look at in certain angles and ways, but really, I just don't agree with it. And also the people moan about violence, there is tons of other movies out there which have more violence, and you go into an R-rated movie, you gotta expect some sort of swearing, some sexual action, some sort of disturbing imagery, or violence. You gotta expect that from an R-rated movie. And not only that, if you know the Joker character and you come out and going, oh, do you know what, that was quite violent, you don't know the Joker, seriously, because this is a Joker movie, perfect, really is. And the last good thing I want to bring up is how they use the Wayne name in this movie. Now, we actually get to see some Waynes, and we get to hear about them, and they're involved somewhat, somehow. I don't want to spoil it for you guys. But the way they used it was really well molded into the story, and I'm really looking forward to seeing what they do with the Waynes, as well as what they do with the Joker in the future. So guys, going into the critics' ratings, I do not have any bad points. I could nitpick a few little things like not too much action, maybe a bit slow pacing, but really, overall, I generally was happy with everything. I wouldn't change a thing. So the critics' ratings, we have IMDb giving it a 9 out of 10, Rotten Tomatoes giving it a 69%, and Metacritic giving it a 58. My rating for this movie is a 10 out of 10. That makes this an amazing movie. Guys, this is the second time this year I've given a 10 out of 10, the first time being The Green Book. I'm a big, big Joker fan. I'm glad with everything how they handled this movie. I left the cinema really, really happy. This movie is a must-see with even all that controversy. I'd forget it, go in, see it yourself, and come out and see how you feel about the movie. And guys, I have to see this movie again before it stops showing in cinemas. I'm really, really a big fan of this movie, and when it comes out on DVD or Blu-ray, I'm definitely going to get it. A 10 out of 10 for Joker from me. Don't forget to let me know your ratings and thoughts in the comment section down below. Did you love it? Did you hate it? Let me know what you think of my thoughts and my rate in the comment section down below. Let's get into a great discussion down there. As well as, guys, I've just started a brand new YouTube series called Best of Horror, going through a bunch of great horror movies, which I'm going to be reviewing for you guys. I want you guys to get involved, though, on this channel a lot more. Let me know your recommendations for reviews, for ranking videos, or even trailer reactions in the comment section down below, or on my Twitter at jspring94. I tend to put polls on there as well, which you can vote for the next reviews and videos coming up on the channel as well. So I'm really sort of active on there, and I want you guys to get involved, and really, especially on this Best of Horror YouTube series, I've already done the review for The Witch, which will be a link in the description and annotation at the end of the video, as well as the new polls put up on Twitter, and The Shining was the one which won the most votes, so that'll be up on the channel tomorrow, so stay tuned for that. But guys, please do get involved. There will be another poll going up tomorrow on my Twitter, so you can get involved and let me know what you want me to put on the channel. I really want to get you guys involved and enjoying my content coming on the channel. Thank you very much for watching, guys. I've been me, you've been you. I'll see you next time, guys, on Talking with Jay Springett.